Oh, it's amazing because we premiered in Venice, but this is the first time we're showing it to a predominantly English-speaking audience. So we're very excited and looking forward to seeing what that will bring. For me, it was all about the script. Rita Carnier had written a beautiful play that she then wrote the screenplay for. And I was so inspired by how unsentimental it was and the kind of humour that was in there that was really unusual. And because I don't write, I have to find people that have similar sensibilities to me. And this really did. And it was also incredibly emotional. And I just thought that the synergy of all these elements was perfect for my first feature film. Well, in Australia, he's actually done a lot of comedic roles over the years, so we know how funny he is. And but actually, I watched him perform in this amazing music video of Sia's, which was at a concert, and it really moved me to tears, and it made me think I definitely need to get him in the film for both his emotional depth and also for his incredible comedic timing. There is no average day. It's always different. I think what you just have to know is that it's going to be fun, it's going to be playful, and you cannot predict what's going to happen. And that's what I like. I like a grenade on set that is never going to let me sit back and relax, and that's what I want as a director. I'm about to direct Killing Eve season 3. I'm directing 2 episodes of that. So I'm actually in pre-production for that now, and I start shooting in about 2 weeks. So I'll experience that very soon. But I'm really looking forward to it. She's amazing, and Sandra Oh's amazing, and the whole cast. I'm just, yeah, it's going to be wonderful.
Babyteeth is a film that I am, you know, I can't overstate how much I love and am proud of this film. I think it's the coolest film that I've ever been in. It's a very feminine film in the most muscular, sort of beautiful, complex, funny, cool way. I love this film so much. So I'm really proud to be here. And the other thing about it, like there's like 4 or 5 people here on this press line. But this film is worth more than its weight in gold, in my opinion. And I kind of love that it's just being born out this way, because for mine this film is a monster, and I think it, knock on wood, this one will stand the test of time very well indeed. I don't have a preference for you know, like villains or comedy or this or that or the other. What I hope is that the film as a whole, or the television show as a whole, or the play, I just hope the thing works. That's my main driver. And I hope that I hope that they find their audience and that people dig it and that they're entertained by them. That's more important to me than what I do. I didn't want to, I'm glad to have the opportunity to be in a range of things and do a range of performances and styles. And I guess that's a lucky thing with being around for a long time, is that I've had the opportunity over time, pardon me, to do a range of things. And you know, if it can keep going, I'm happy with that. Next is going to be, I have a series at HBO called The Outsider, which is a Stephen King adaptation, which is made by Jason Bateman, who's also doing Ozark. That will come out in January, and that I'm hearing good things about it, so that sounds good.